Sun Tzu said, in the operations of war, where there are in the field 1,000 swift chariots, as many heavy chariots, and 100,000 mail-clad soldiers, with provisions enough to carry them 1,000 li. The expenditure at home and at the front, including entertainment of guests, small items, such as glue and paint, and some spent on chariots and armor, will reach the total of 1,000 ounces of silver per day. Such is the cost of raising an army of 100,000 men. When you engage in actual fighting, victory is long in coming, the men's weapons will grow dull, and their ardor will be damped. If you lay siege to a town, you will exhaust your strength. Again, if the campaign is protracted, the resources of the state will not be equal to the strain. Now, when your weapons are dull, your strength exhausted, your treasure spent, other chieftains will spring up to take advantage of your extremity. Then no man, however wise, will be able to avert the consequences that must ensue. Thus, though we have heard of stupid haste in war, cleverness has never been seen associated with long delays. There is no instance of a country having benefited from prolonged warfare. It is only one who is thoroughly acquainted with the evils of war that can thoroughly understand the profitability, the profitable way of carrying it out. The skillful soldier does not raise a second levy, neither are his supply wagons loaded than twice. Bring more material with you from home, but forage on the enemy. Thus, the army will have food enough for its needs. Poverty of the state extraquire causes an army to be maintained by contributions from a distance. Contributing to maintain an army at a distance causes the people to be impoverished. On the other hand, the proximity of an army causes prices to go up, and high prices cause the people's substances to be drained away. When their substance is drained away, the pleasantry will be affiliated by heavy exactions. With this loss of substance and exhaustion of strength, the homes of the people will be stripped bare, as 3/10 of their incomes will be dissipated, while government expenses for broken chariots, worn-out horses, breastplates and helmets, bows and arrows, spears and shields, protective materials, draught oxen, and heavy wagons will amount to 4/10 of its revenue. Hence, a wise general makes a point of foraging on the enemy. One cartload of the enemy's provisions is equivalent to 20 of one's own, and likewise a single bequel of his provender is equivalent to 20 for one's own store. Now, in order to kill the enemy, our men must be roused to anger, that they may be advantaged from defeating the enemy. They must have their rewards. Therefore, in chariot fighting, when 10 or more chariots have been taken, those should be rewarded who took the first. Our own flag should be substituted for those of the enemy, and the chariots mingled and used in conjunction with our own. The captured soldiers should be kindly treated and kept. This is called using the conquered foe to please leave a like and subscribe. I'm sorry about all the pronunciation errors. I've tried this multiple times. It's not gonna stop. I am so sorry. Yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video.